My name is Cynthia Dunbar, and I feel constrained by the Holy Spirit to not give you any other title than I am a servant of the Most High God, a sinner redeemed by the precious blood of the Lamb. And I just want us to be grateful today, to have hearts of gratitude for this nation in which we live, that was founded upon the belief that all men are created equal and endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. The governments were instituted among men to preserve those rights, and that when the government becomes destructive of that ends, that it's the right of the people to alter it. There's a formal legal writ over here at one of the tents that you can sign because our government has become destructive of those ends, and the burden and the authority has shifted to us, we the people, to stand up and make the changes. And so I encourage you to go by and sign that. But Father, we thank you and praise you that you are a merciful God, that your mercies are new every morning. And God, my heart breaks for our nation as I realize the gift that you have given to us, Lord, that we have taken for granted. Lord, your word says that judgment begins in the house of the Lord. God, we don't look to any groups, any other organizations, or even elected officials to point the finger, God, because we have to look first to ourselves in our apathy and our lack of stepping in to what you've called us to do. And Lord, pertaining to the education of our children, Lord, your word says that if any of us would lead one of these little ones astray, that it would be worse for us than if a millstone were wrapped around our neck and we'd be cast into the sea. God, that we have looked to the government as our source of educating our youth, Father. That you hold us each accountable for training up our children in the way that they should go, Lord. And that instead of taking on that responsibility heartily as unto you, God, that we have looked to the civil rulers. And so, Father, I just pray. I pray, God, that you would forgive us for abdicating our role and our responsibility. I pray, God, that you would cause us to be light. Father, the light has shone into the darkness, and the darkness knew it not. God, help us to be light. Help us to be salt and light. Father, your word to the children of Israel was, remember all the ways which the Lord thy God led thee. And Father, I believe that's your heart for our nation, that we would remember the providential hand of God upon our nation and upon its founding. Father, that as our founding fathers told us that we could not deny the providence of God in establishing us as a nation. And Lord, forgive us that we have trained generation after generation to not know that it's the providential hand of God. But even beyond that, God, that we have not even allowed them that was the viewpoint of our founding fathers. Lord, I pray, Father God, that you would hear us. Lord, you tell us that your hand is not shortened, that you cannot save, and your ear is not closed, that you do not hear. But God, you don't hear because of the iniquities, because of the blood on our hand, because we of all people, God, know the truth, and we see the sword of judgment coming, Lord, but we have not spoken up to warn. And Father, I just pray that you would give us a heart that would desire to save those around us who don't know the truth, Lord. That we would not be condemning, but we would speak out the truth out of a heart of compassion and conviction to see those who are in darkness be brought to light. Father, I thank you. I thank you, God, that you can turn this situation around in a second. And Lord, I ask that you would invade our schools, invade our country, invade our homes, invade our churches with your presence, that we would truly be hunger for righteousness and for truth. God, that we have trained generation upon generation to believe that there are whole areas of instruction, knowledge, wisdom, and truth that can be found absent and devoid the presence of the Most High God. Lord, forgive us for believing and confessing that with our actions, God, because we know that truth has a name. And it is the name by which everyone shall be saved. It's the name by which every knee shall bow and every tongue confess. It's the name above all names, God, because truth is not a thing. It is a person. And it is the person of Jesus Christ. And your word tells us that if you be lifted up, you will draw all men unto you. And so, God, that's what we do right now. We repent on behalf of our nation. We repent on behalf of ourselves and our families, God. And we lift you up. And we want to see you exalted, God. That you would be able to move and draw all men unto you. And we give you all the glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.